Hello, Daizan here from Zenways. So I had a question about acupoints and how we use acupoints in practice and this kind of thing. So the traditional temple schedule doesn't run on days of the week. It runs on days of the month. And they have what are called shikunichi. So any day with a 4 or a 9 in the date is a kind of a sort of a maintenance day, really. So the 4th, the 9th, the 14th, the 19th day of the month, and so on. And these days are often called needle and moxa days. Needle, as in, you know, mending your robes and so on. Moxa is a kind of like an incense, which you can put on acupoints and then light it, and the heat going through the points actually sort of stimulates those and tones up your system. But I have learned some points along the way which seem to be quite nice, quite helpful. So let's just have a look at a few. So classic point, very nice one, easy to find really, is if you run your thumb down the inside of your index finger into the web of your hand here, but we're on the side of the index finger, and there's a point in there that's quite distinct, quite easy to find. And when you press into this point, now I was taught this was a really good one for sort of stagnation in the body. You know, when there's a sense of things kind of a bit claggy, headaches, this kind of stuff, stagnation generally. So you can press into this point using a thumb, maybe 10, 15 seconds. That works pretty well. Now with all of these points, you've got a left, and then you've got the same on the right, okay? So down the side of the index finger into the web there, and it's distinctly more tender than the area around it. So that's quite a nice one to find. All right, and then if you find the wrist kind of bracelet, you know, the wrinkles that are around the bracelet, and then about 2 fingers width or so up from there, there's a point in the center of the wrist. And this one's kind of around the heart and the heart surrounding area. It's the way it was described to me was like, this is the point to press when everything's just falling apart in your life, when it's just like, you know, craziness and chaos. And this enables your heart just to let go of all that and just kind of carry on regardless, you know, that kind of point. Again, all of these points, 10 seconds, 15 seconds, you know, that's a fairly easy one to find. And then there's one, if you kind of fold your elbow a little bit and then put your thumb into the crook of the elbow and come back a little ways from there. So it's kind of on the kind of outside of the arm, about here, a couple of fingers width or so back. Again, fairly easy to find. Now, this one was described to me as kind of like your antiseptic point, great for your immune system. So this one can really come into focus when you're fighting off a cold or an infection, that kind of thing. Again, quite nice. You can press into this one. It seems to be easier to find when you have got some sort of cold going on. So mine, I've got a cold at the moment, and it's quite clear and obvious. Other times, not so much. So you can press into this one. So if we find the kneecap like this, can you see that? Is that visible? All right, so a couple of fingers width below the kneecap, and then just outside the knee in here. There's a point which is a lot less distinct than these other ones, although there's something of a tenderness within this. Now this point here, they call it the leg 3 mile point. Apparently soldiers back in ancient China and stuff, when they were marching long route marches and so on, would press on this point and get an extra 3 miles, as it were. So it's good for leg issues. Quite often, you know, when we've got a lot of sitting going on, people are feeling it a lot in their legs, and this is a really nice point for giving the legs a bit of a boost. Okay, so again, 10 seconds, 15 seconds. So just a little bit down from the kneecap and out, left and right. Okay, and then a fifth one, if you find your ankle bone, okay, the inside of your leg, about three fingers width directly above the ankle bone. There's a very easy point to find. So this one, it's on the kidney energy line, the spleen energy line, and also the liver energy line. So it's called three yin crossing in the translated name for it. Gives all of those energy lines a bit of a boost. It's a very good general well-being kind of energy line. Now, I'm told we don't do this one if you're heavily pregnant. It apparently can bring on early childbirth, this kind of thing. But assuming you're not heavily pregnant, it's a good one for almost everybody. Good for the legs, good for the general body, sort of well-being, balance, energy, and so on. So there's five points you can explore. Obviously, there's many, many more through the body. It's pretty easy to find out background information about these. It can be nice to explore through your body, just actually find the spots within you which are particularly tender, particularly tight, and just getting a sense of where tension can release, where there are, as it were, spots which are calling for your attention. Over time, this stuff seems to come into focus more and more. Now, you can absolutely incorporate this sort of thing within your yoga practice. For example, you know, this one, you can kind of build a sort of a side stretch in with that, or something like that, or you can go backwards with that one. You can similarly with this one, you can find that stagnation point and then work forward into a stretch while you're working the point. I recommend just let this be part of your general exploration as a yoga practitioner, as a Zen practitioner. It can be a good move if you've got somebody in your life who's like a real specialist in this, like a really good acupuncturist or a really good shiatsu person. Particularly as an ongoing practitioner, it can be really good to go and get a kind of an MOT every now and again. Just get the whole system checked out, get some things moving on the energetic level. Shinkai over at Blue Cliff in America runs some seasonal related seminars around some of this material. And you can join in with him. He runs online kind of events around that. But I particularly recommend just letting your body speak to you. And if this dimension of practice is one which comes up for you, then please go ahead. You know, it's absolutely there within the tradition. You're not adding in extra levels. It's pretty widespread. And in my experience, pretty beneficial, pretty directly beneficial. So please enjoy exploring. So five ways that Zenways can help you. Number one, you can have a look at our book, which provides a foundation, Zen practice. Practical Zen, it's called, easy to find. And you can also work with a Zenways trained teacher. That'll give you a foundation. Now, based on that, you might be interested in number two, which is practicing with a community, actually joining with us. All donations based, you can become a Zenways member. Now, based on that again, you might find that you want to explore the movement work that we have within our practice as well. Zazen is sitting meditation. Dozen means essentially meditation in action or in movement. Number four, based on all of this work, you might want to come and join us for a retreat. We have six or eight of those available every year. You'd be very welcome. They also are donations based. Number five, you might want to become a meditation and mindfulness teacher. You might want to become a yoga teacher with Zenways. We have two externally validated professional trainings. Those aren't based on donations. There's a charge there, but that charge helps to foster all the other work that we do. Easiest thing of all, you can subscribe here on YouTube. You can click the notification bell.